Hello, this is Rupinder Syal and welcome to Spartan Tutorials. Today we are going to talk about a technique to create knockout mice. These are the mice where genes have been knocked out, that is, both the copies of the gene in the mice have been deleted, and this is very important to understand gene function in their endogenous context, that means where the genes are actually present in the chromosome. So let's talk about the creation of knockout mice today. The technique for developing transgenic mice which have genes knocked out was pioneered by three researchers, Mario Capecchi, Sir Martin Evans and Oliver Smithies, and they were instrumental in developing the use of embryonic stem cells to create transgenic mice, and from this they improved the technology to create gene knockout mice. So the technology for creating knockout mice relies on creating suitable targeting vector which can insert themselves into the locus of interest, so the gene of interest that you are targeting, by homologous recombination. Now this is achieved in a number of different ways, and we also introduce a concept called positive negative selection to make sure that we are selecting only the cells which are carrying our insertion. So this is the design of the targeting vector. We have, this is the target gene that you are interested in, so this is in the genome, so in our case this will be mouse genome, and here we have neomycin resistance gene inserted, and these regions are basically homologous, and along with that the targeting vector also contains thymidine kinase gene. This is important for the negative selection. Now the hope is that due to homologous recombination, when we transfect this targeting vector into the cells, into the embryonic stem cells or the ES cells, the hope is that due to recombination, the neomycin resistance gene as well as the homologous arms will replace the target gene, in effect creating a knockout, because this will create a huge insertion in the target gene and this will knock out the gene. That's the hope. Okay. Now there are two scenarios where this can happen. One scenario is the optimal required outcome, which is the exact gene targeting that we are interested in at our locus of interest. So what will happen is you have your target gene in the mouse chromosome. You have your targeting vector with neomycin resistance gene. This confers resistance to neomycin. So if we use neomycin in the selection medium, we can select cells which have neomycin resistance. And also the thymidine kinase which is encoded by this virus, HSV. So HSV will not get integrated, only the homologous region plus the neomycin resistance gene will get incorporated. So the final cell, final transgenic cell, will have the insertion in the targeted gene and it will contain the neomycin resistance, but it will not contain the thymidine kinase. So it will be neomycin resistance, but it will not have thymidine kinase. Now the other process that can happen, the off-target effect, that is the random integration, this can also happen if there is a slight chance of some homology between your sequence and the another chromosomal location. Then we have this random gene, and here what will happen is you can see the red neomycin resistance gene as well as the blue thymidine kinase gene, both of them will get integrated and this cell will be neomycin resistant and it will be thymidine kinase positive. So it will express thymidine kinase. Now here is where we select using positive and negative selection. So this is called positive negative selection. So let's see how it works. In the medium, we use neomycin. So So only the cells which can grow in the presence of neomycin will grow. So non-transgenic cells will definitely die off. So both of these cells will survive this. And in addition, we use a drug called ganciclovir. It has various different spellings. Sometimes it is also spelled with a I. So ganciclovir. The interesting thing is when thymidine kinase works on ganciclovir, it converts it into, let me write it here, a toxic product. And it will lead to cell death because of the toxicity caused by this metabolic byproduct. So the cells which have randomly integrated your transgene will die off. So this is the advantage of this dual method of positive negative selection. You use neomycin as well as ganciclovir in the selection medium, in the growth medium, and that will hopefully allow only these cells to survive and not these cells. Okay, so that's the concept of positive negative selection. Now what we do is we have already done the transfection part. Now we grow these ES cells. So hopefully our ES cell who has all the required transgene has been identified. We use positive negative selection and we grow this population of ES cells carrying targeted gene. So this will create a small mass of cells which will be the ES cells containing the transgene. And now what will happen is we will inject these cells into a new embryo. So we will harvest embryos from a mouse and we will inject it into the blastocyst. Okay, so blastocyst, as you know, it's the developing embryo. It has specific cells which constitute the trophectoderm, which is the nourishing part of the embryo, as well as the inner cell mass which develops the embryo, which forms the embryo proper. So these cells will be incorporated into the inner cell mass and this will give rise to a chimeric mouse, because some of these genes, some of these cells will be from the original non-transgenic cells. So they will not carry the transgene and some will be the knocked out cells. Now here we have injected our ES cells into the blastocysts and they will incorporate it into the mosaic inner cell mass and it will be incorporated into a surrogate mother. Usually these are pseudo pregnant females who have been mated with a vasectomized mouse. So the mouse which cannot produce sperm because of the vasectomy, but they are, because of the act of copulation, they are still pseudo pregnant. So we incorporate our blastocyst, we implant them into their uterus, and then we look at our next progeny. This is the process of microinjection. This is a pretty standard technique in mouse manipulation. We have our chimeric mouse. Now here you can see the blotching of the different speckles here. This just shows that okay, some cells are transgenic and some cells are not. And by breeding these mice again and again, we can generate a population which is homozygous knockout. Okay, that's the idea here. So we have our chimeric mouse, and if we breed it with normal mouse, we can get gene targeted mice, and those are the mice that we are interested in. And we also get some proportion of normal mice, so we can segregate them and study these mice for any defects that we are interested in studying. Now this technology has led to a huge explosion of research in developing mouse models for various diseases, because mice and humans are very much close. Mouse researchers like to say that the mice are basically small humans, and that is partially true, because 99% of our genes share a very strong similarity in terms of coding as well as non-coding sequence. And this technology has helped researchers in developing mouse models of several debilitating diseases. For example, here you can see a paper where they developed a mouse model of cystic fibrosis, which affects a lot of newborn children every year. the mouse models have been developed for Leishman-Hand syndrome, which is characterized by neurological abnormalities, and there is impulsive biting and pulling of the skin in this disease, and it is caused by problems in this gene, hypoxanthine phosphoribosyl transferase. And you can see actually the over grooming, which is the mouse equivalent of, you know, nail biting and scratching in the humans in this mouse model. And you can also see a lot of oncomice have been developed. These are mouse models of cancers. So various cancer related genes, for example, here we have APC gene, P53 genes, they have been knocked out, and their phenotypes have been studied, and their evidence have been studied how important they are for cancer progression as well as metastasis. So the technology for creating knockout mice has helped in elucidating basic biology, and it is very relevant to studying diseases in a very human-like context. So very useful technology, and that's why it was awarded with the Nobel Prize, because it has been such a big contributor to basic as well as applied research. So that was my discussion of knockout mice. Let me know if you have any doubts or questions about it. As usual, please do subscribe to my channel and give it a thumbs up if you like the video. Till the next time we meet, take care and bye-bye.